Hello and welcome back to the Nash Metal Production Channel here on YouTube. Welcome to another 70's Hard and Heavy video. And for this one, like I pretty much announced in my last one, which of course was UK late 70's Hard and Heavy, at the end of that one, I said that this would be focused on Germany. So that's what you're going to get here. However, though, there's only two albums here I'm going to be showing. So, with that, two of them all basically go hand in hand with each other when it comes to the band itself. So, without further ado, let's get in. Again, I don't have any Lucifer's Friend. I don't have any of the really early Mass albums. I don't have... just some of those I don't have. What the hell did I get? Whatever, something came on my phone, I don't know what the hell it is. Anyways, those are some of the ones I don't, however, the band I have, yes, I do have this band, though I don't have the rest of their 70s stuff, but this is the only one that I have from the 70s. It's a great record, though. I really love this album. That's, of course, is Love Drive from Scorpions. This, of course, is the U.S. pressing. I've got the CD copy that has the European uncensored cover with, of course, the two, like the male and the lady on the front with the guy basically with the goop or so on covering like what the lady's boob. Yeah, I've got that cover, but on vinyl, no. Anyways, again, I don't have this band's, the rest of their 70s stuff. I don't have the ones with like Uli John Roth, or I don't have the first sound with Michael Schenker on it, but still, this is a great album, though. This is still very much in line with 70s Hard and Heavy. This, of course, was released in 1979, but this is just a killer album, I would say. Some of the, definitely one of the hardest rocking songs on the sound would be Another Piece of Meat. Even Coast to Coast is a damn good instrumental. Can't Get Enough is a real fast speed rocker. Of course, even the song Love Drive also has a real good heavy beat around it. But I also like Loving You Sunday Morning. I like that track on here. Even I kind of like the sort of reggae feel of Is There Anybody There? Holiday, though, is a great ballad, of course. Scorpions, when it comes to the ballads by the Scorpions, almost any of the ballads are pretty much bound to be great. They're not just made for radio play. They are really just honest, heartfelt ballads. That's one of the main things that make Scorpions, when it comes to their ballads, what makes them such a good band. So, Love Drive, just a killer album. I'm, of course, going to be showing a clip here. Instead of taking from my CD copy, this is actually a vinyl rip of the song and other piece of meat, so... here's your sample, so enjoy, so I can get into the next one and last one, so... Alright, time for the last album here of the show. Like, again, two albums, but, you know, I'm going to try, hopefully this at least turns out to be at least a good 1-2 punch. Maybe not, who knows. Whatever, I'm only doing this because I like to talk about these albums. This is 70s Hard and Heavy, so anything that's got a real hard rock sound to a real heavy sound gets talked about. Even if it's all I have, I'm talking about it. So when it comes to this, and when it comes to 70s Scorpions... I don't have any of the 70s Scorpions. However, when it comes to the guitar player, Uli John Roth, I do have. And I do have his debut that was released in 1979. That's, of course, his Electric Sun, Earthquake. A little brain fart there. Still, when it comes to 70s Scorpions, I don't own any of those albums. However, this sound right here, even if I don't own it, this sound does the trick, actually. This one, of course, though I'll still have to get that one, is Firewind, I think, is the title of the album after this one, which probably is better than this one, but this is still is a damn solid Scorpions. Now, this is basically right there, I would say, next to, like, Virgin Killer in terms of the same kind of style. It's like, basically, Uli John Roth is just a damn fine, great guitar player, but he's one of the main reasons for why Scorpions sound the way that it did on albums such as Fly to the Rainbow, Entrance, or Virgin Killer, and of course, Taken by Force. He's the reason those albums sound the way that they do. When they got rid of him, you definitely could tell that they definitely lost that sort of aspect of those albums on the Love Drive album. It really kind of, even though Love Drive is a great record, it's not, though, near the quality that Uli John Roth brought to the Scorpions. And on this album, he definitely shows why he was such a key part of those 70 Scorpions albums to begin with. He was basically, even though Michael Schenker was a great guitar player, loved that guy, but Uli John Roth just added something extra, something more special to Scorpions' sound. He was the reason for why, like, again, those albums were, and this album is definitely no exception. This is just a great album. The track that starts off the album, Electric Sun, just a fucking killer track. Burning Wheels Turning, another great track. I also love Japanese Dream. Sundown, another killer rocker. Still So Many Miles Away is also good. And of course, the last track, the title track, the 10-minute or over 10-minute, 31-second title track. There's a reason for why Uli John Roth was pretty much looked as such an influence to guys like Yngwie Malmsteen. You can hear that, though. I think Yngwie Malmsteen is less the man that Uli John Roth is, though. Like, Uli John Roth is a much more honest guy, while Yngwie was just, you could just say he was only just hyping up, just to try and just jump on the sort of train. Even though Yngwie is a good guitar player, but when it comes to the honest, sort of real down-to-earth kind of attitude, Yngwie doesn't come near or close to the attitude of Uli John Roth. It's like Uli John Roth, in many ways, if you were going to get those two, I think Uli would probably school the fuck out of Yngwie in many ways. So, enough talking. This is just a great album from Uli John Roth. Great debut, though, when it comes to his guitar playing or his best work. Probably his went with the Scorpions, but this is still an exception to check out. Definitely a great album. So with that, to end it out, here's your sample, and with that, I'll be back here tomorrow, I would say, with another Canada video, which of course will be Canada, late 70s. So with that, until then, this is Hip with Fresh Sam out, and I'll see you later. Everyone, take care.